Hey guys! Oh, I know it's New Year's Eve, but I had to get on here live. So, first, before we get started, I'm gonna start doing videos the way that you should be doing them live. And so, that just I hope will get you in the habit of doing videos. So, wasn't that video from Amber the other day super amazing? So, I actually just went live on my business page. And I think I was thinking to myself, you know, when I go live in here, I should really treat it the same way. So I will start it like, hey, you know, thanks for joining. I probably won't start it like this every time, but another tribe of birds. And I love helping women achieve their God-sized dreams. I love helping them go from average to awesome. And if this is your first time tuning in, like that's what I would say. Like, my name is Heather Schreiber, right? I literally just did this. I had it written out because I'm like, oh my gosh, right? Amber gave some really great tips. And so, you guys, you can watch videos all day long. And if you don't actually apply those tips to your business, what's the point? You know, think, really ask yourself, how many of you watched some of those 12 Days of Christmas videos and you were in awe and you thought those things were so awesome? And then maybe you didn't actually put anything to practice. So it's like you just wasted your time. So what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to do my lives very similar to what you guys should be doing live on your personal pages, in your groups, everything. It should be everywhere. And we should just get in the habit of hearing these things and seeing these things. So I feel like it's gotta start with someone, right? It's gotta start with me. So besides the introduction, if you are tuning in live, I would love you to drop a one below and tell me, are you staying in for New Year's or are you going out? And then if you are on the replay, drop a two below and tell me, did you get a New Year's kiss? So, all right, let's get started because I wanted to pop on here and just share a little bit of my heart because I shared it with my first buying group and I thought, gosh, you know, I should really probably share it with everybody. So something happens when you get success and all of a sudden sometimes people feel like you are like magical and you know everything or things come easy to you or I don't know. It just seems like, you know, it's funny when I share the truth of my journey of just the entrepreneur life, right? And with Cenogens, and sometimes people are like shocked to hear it. And so I shared it in my first line page. So I have been, and this is a whole other video I'm gonna do later, once I can kind of really tie everything together, but I just had like an epiphany over the last couple weeks. So I have been in a really strange place with my business and trying to figure out like what is my problem? Like what's going on with me, right? By the way, I can't see any comments, so I'm gonna pop out and pop back in. Okay, cool. So, hey Jen, hey Christy. So I've been in a really weird place with my business and success and, you know, I'm making sales, I'm still sponsoring people. I'm just in a really weird place. And I'm like trying to figure out what it is. And I really feel like I have been self-sabotaging. It's no secret that the success that you know, we have experienced in 2017 and thanks to you guys was just truly mind-blowing and amazing. And there's something about it that's almost made me like cautious, you know, over the last few months. And besides my life and all the craziness going on, if you guys don't know all the craziness with our health and all that stuff, I just realized I think I've been self-sabotaging my success. And so I'm kind of in this almost like having to treat myself like a baby entrepreneur and like remind myself, what are the things you need to do? You need to do positive affirmations. You need to tell yourself. You need to write these things out and put them everywhere so you can see them. All kinds of stuff. So, anyways, with self-sabotaging, I was going live on my business page. So there's your Facebook page, your personal page. There is your Facebook group, which is what I refer to as your store. And then there's your business page, right? Some of you may have one, some of you may don't. But I have had one for the past 3 years, and I really grew mine over the last 2 years on Facebook. And I was going live like 2 to 3 times a week, like all the time, just regularly. And some of you I've sponsored from going live. So you get to meet me and see my personality and all that stuff. Well, over the last few months, I don't know where or along the way, like whatever happened, the self-sabotaging, right? I stopped going live for one reason or another. I stopped going live on my business page. You guys, I go live in here. I go live in my personal. I will even go live on my personal. I mean, I'll go live anywhere, but the business page was just for some reason, I started to let it like freak me out. And I am not afraid to talk to people, right? But my business page, there was just, for one reason or another, I could make 100 excuses as to why or reasons why, but I just wasn't doing it. And so I went live tonight. I told myself the last week, you are going live and you're going to share why people should ditch their New Year's resolutions and they should instead choose a word for the year. And that's what I've been doing for the past 4 years, and it's totally changed my life. And here it is, New Year's Eve, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I haven't gone live yet. Some days it's because I didn't do my makeup. Some days it's because Dylan's crying. Some days it's because it's 10 o'clock at night and nobody's gonna, you know, whatever. Whatever reason, right? But I promised myself I was gonna go live and I was going to share that with people because I feel like that helps. And it's something that's helpful to people and it's something that's not business related, right? It's just helping. And I did it. And I literally had butterflies in my stomach before I hit the go live button. And I shared that with some girls, girls I personally sponsor, and they're like, I just can't believe like you're even afraid to go live at all. Like you don't seem like you are. I'm like, well, I don't, not really anywhere else except my business page. And I don't know why I've been having this weird, like I said, self-sabotaging myself and in my success. And so I wanted to encourage you guys. So much of this and so much of this journey is doing things that scare you and making yourself proud. And when you make yourself proud, you build your confidence in who you are, and then you kind of walk a little bit taller. You feel literally there is like a high that you get, literally, like the high that you get from just doing something that scares you, the adrenaline rush, like it's literally a physical thing. And I went live, and every time I go live before I hit the button, it doesn't matter which group it is, I always pray, God, give me the words. God, give me the words, because it's live, and you really like never know exactly what you're gonna say. And so I know it's scary, but you guys, if you're not going live, you're going to get lost. You're going to get lost in everybody else who is willing to punch fear in the face and who is willing to step outside their comfort zone and do it. And so maybe your fear is not going live. Maybe it's something else. But what I wanted to hop on here and encourage you guys to do before the end of the year, you still have a few hours, do one thing that scares you. One thing that has been eating at you for weeks or months or maybe this whole year. Just do one thing that is going to just scare you a little bit. But ultimately what that's going to do is going to make you so proud. It's gonna make you so proud, right? Yes, Lorraine, it is so much fun. And I can go live in my groups all the time. I used to go live on my page all the time. But over the last few months, there's just been something in my head and I just kind of stopped. It's weird. But anyways, I did it tonight and I feel so proud of myself. And my confidence is already like back up there. And I went downstairs and I was like, babe, I did it. And he's like, what? I was like, I went live. And he's like, girl. He's like, what? He didn't say girl. But he's like, you go live all the time. I'm like, no, like I went live on my business page and I like did an intentional, you know, video, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, you know, but I'm happy. So you still have a few hours. And I want you to know, again, so much of this journey is just self-growth. It's not necessarily how big your paycheck is and all of these things. It is growth, stretching yourself, getting outside your comfort zone, proving that you can do something that you maybe are afraid to do or maybe you thought you never could do, but you totally can do it. So I would love for you, if you're watching this, either now or before the end of whenever you watch the replay, share. What's the one thing you're gonna do? What is the one thing that's scaring you? Maybe it's inviting that one person to the business that you just know would be amazing, but there's just something about that person that scares you, right? Go invite them. Maybe it is the customer that, I don't know, that you have talked to 6 times about ordering and she just hasn't done it and you want to follow up with her one more time and do that 7th time, right? And by the way, it takes 7 to 8 times typically to touch someone or to bring up something for someone to actually commit. And I have a whole other story on that later. It's actually another post I'm going to go live about this week. Ooh, well, I kicked my little stand. So, anyways, whatever it is, share something. Make yourself proud. Before the end of 2017, make yourself proud. I can tell you, like, internally, I just feel so excited about 2018 and so much more confident, right, about going into 2018. Even just that little thing that I did that I used to do all the time that didn't even bother me at all before, but for some reason the last few months has just been eating at me, and I just wasn't doing it enough. And I did it, and I'm proud of myself. So make yourself proud. Do something tonight. Let me see if I can see some comments. A former employee of mine who is a stay-at-home mom, and she would kill this business. Yes, Lauren, go invite her. Yes. What do you have to lose? She's gonna maybe say no. Okay, right? She says no, and you're like, all right, I'm gonna follow up with you in a couple months too, and I'm still keep being your friend, right? So drop below what you're gonna do, and if you watch this and it's already New Year's, y'all, you can be a different you at any moment. You can be somebody different than you were 5 seconds ago, right? So if you're watching the replay and you missed the 2017 mark and the ball dropped and it's midnight, whatever, who cares? You can be a different person at any given moment. So choose to make yourself proud. Choose to do something that scares you. And I promise you, you will, if you do that every week, something, just something to help grow yourself and stretch yourself, you're gonna have a crazy, massive, successful 2018. So I'm so excited to do life with you guys. I'm so excited to do business. I don't know, I just have this really like fire in my belly about 2018. And I didn't really have it all leading up until really just like this last week, I just have this crazy feeling. And I just want you to know, my intuition is always right. So you're either on this train or you're not. But if you're watching, you're definitely on it, and I'm super excited to do this with you. So here's to a life of abundance and blessings and crazy success in 2018. Happy New Year's. I love you guys. Go do something that scares you. Go make yourself proud.